You look at your marriage. You look at your life. Look at your life right now. Look at your marriage right now. And maybe look at the tone of the marriage. Look at the tone of the marriage and find out that the reason why that tone, that anger is in there, the reason why that thing is in there is because we don't understand what marriage is. We don't. The reason why we can get so angry at each other, the reason why we have become so selfish and so self-centered and so angry is because we don't understand marriage. Some of us have hurried into marriages because we thought we could just walk in there like I did, just stumble your way into it. But here is the deal. If you don't know marriage, you cannot marry right. If you don't know the full meaning of marriage, you cannot marry right. And how I wish somebody had pulled me to the side and said, Sam, let me tell you, what you are going to get into is not your Facebook and your Skype conversations. This is not it. You are entering into a whole new ball game. I wish somebody would have pulled me to the side and said that, but nobody did. So here I am, walking blind and just walking blind, going about things blindly and ineffectively. And again, you look into your marriage and there's insult. There is anger. If you love someone, if you truly, truly love someone, how do you dishonor them with anger? How do you even allow yourself to be angry and express the anger, unleash the anger on them? How? If you truly understand what marriage is, how would you do that? How would you do that? It's because we don't understand. And if we truly understand marriage, insults will not have any place in the marriage. You will not even think about, God forbid, that I use an inappropriate word on the person. And that's because we don't understand marriage. Then we look at the actions in the marriage. All of a sudden, people stop talking. We know it. Married couples here, they know it. All of a sudden, people stop eating other people's food. The husband is mad and he's not eating the wife's food. Oh, why? Because he doesn't understand what marriage is. He doesn't. All of a sudden, people stop sleeping with each other. They are married couples, but they are not sleeping together. They are not having any, you know, intimate relationship. They are not having, they don't have sex, they don't have anything. They're just going, everybody's going about their business. And why? Is because he is mad about something, she is not happy about something, nobody's moving into the middle, and we are just going at it. There's also financial abuse. There's no openness in the area of finances. We are not open. The man has his own money. The woman has her own money. Everybody's doing their own thing on the side, just going about things. And then hopefully they'll say, oh, we can get this done together. And if money is on one side more than the other, if there's a disproportional distribution of the money, all of a sudden, the one who has more money thinks they can punish the other one who has less money. And why do we do that? It's because we don't understand what marriage is. We don't understand. And God forbid, maybe not here. And even if it's here, it is done tonight. And all this adds up. And usually, the most heartbreaking thing, it gets to a point where one person has to take out a hand, has to take out something and apply physical force on the other. How painful. And the truth is, this disgusting thing, touching someone, a man who is 4 or 5 times bigger and stronger than the woman, is able to take his hand and use force and apply to someone. How is that right? And the reason why that audacity is even there is because the man doesn't know what he is in. He has drunk the Kool-Aid and he didn't know what the flavor was. He just jumped into it. How disgusting. How shameful. And we have seen the most beautiful thing. Those who have great marriages, we are saying the most beautiful thing, the most amazing thing ever. The most amazing thing ever, which is marriage, which is love, we have taken it and we have shrouded it with all kinds of utter mess and filth. And some marriages are at their breaking point. They are better off not being together than being together, because it is so painful for them to be together. But why is it like that? Because they don't know what they are in there. They stay together, not because of each other, but because of other external forces. They are only married because of the children. The marriage is only hanging on there because of the family. They don't want any family member to know that, you know, they are no longer together. So they are staying in under one roof and things are not going well. They are in there because of a business they started. They are in there because of a financial benefit from one or the other. And because it is painful. It is painful. I'm not talking down on this. I'm only just describing that, yes, these are real issues that are taking place every day. And the reason why it's happening that way is because we do not understand marriage. And for those who say, I don't know what we are talking about. I don't know what we are talking about. An emotional Dr. Vera, God bless you. You are preaching with me and Chanel. That's right. The Kool-Aid analogy. We are drinking the Kool-Aid and we have no idea what the flavor is. That's what is happening. And Vera is saying that there is verbal and emotional, financial. There's so all types of abuse taking place. And the bottom line is we don't understand marriage. And for those who have good things, my marriage is good. I have no problem. We don't argue. We are good. I don't know what you're talking about with all these things. But then you go to the bottom of it and it's just an arrangement. It's a man and a woman going up and down. They are basically polite roommates who sleep occasionally, who have sex occasionally. And that is what they have become. And that is not marriage. The fact that you're not arguing and throwing insults, exchanging insults, doesn't mean that you are having a great marriage. What it is that in the design of marriage, it's supposed to be an infinite debt. There should be no end as to how far the joy, the fulfillment, the richness, the excitement about you, your spouse, your partner. There should be no end to that. That's right. John says, roommates with benefits. There should be no end to that. God wants rich, not polite people, not cordial people, not people who are existing. Not that. But people who are married, intertwined, married. Hey, that is where we are going with this. And then we look around us and 50% divorce rate. That means 5 out of every 10 marriages will fall apart. God forbid. And of the 50% that are left, another half of that is barely making it. And bottom line, we don't understand what marriage is. And because we don't understand what marriage is, it makes the word of God that came to us true, that the devil has been able to sneak into homes and he's waging an unrestrained war on us. But tonight, our prayer is that the Lord will open the eyes of your understanding to what marriage is according to the manufacturer's recommendation, the manufacturer's description. God will open your eyes to that in the name of Jesus. In the name